lift, practice, and repeat. What? Nowadays, the workouts have become twice as hard. That's the territory that comes with starting over.
I almost cried, because it was like, I've gotten to know all my peers for so long. I've been with them, most of them, since almost elementary school and middle school and all those years, and all of a sudden they're telling us we have to split up. We have to go to two different schools.
This summer, Jones High School turned into a Futures Academy and closed its doors on athletics.
See it. What?
Leaving football players like Cody Hayes Tyler with two options: hang it up or begin a new career elsewhere.
See it.
Leaving one school and going to a school that's been your rival, that part is difficult to sink into your mind and in your heart, because as far as he was concerned and the rest of the players at Jones, they had black and gold in their heart. Over here, Sterling, navy blue and Columbia blue.
First, it was like, oh yeah, I have for sure starting spot, so I might as well just, you know, keep on doing what I do. But now it's like, I have to go to a whole different school, and it's like, I have to practice and work twice as hard as I was to gain the respect of those over here, because they probably don't know me as well. So I have to prove myself to them that I'm worthy enough to be their starting quarterback.
Matter of fact, look, run the scene, run the scene. Yeah, see it? Hey.
Now a member of the Sterling Raiders, Cody leads by example through a work ethic derived from pain.
He plays and practices and does everything, you know, in the sign for his brother. And so whatever it takes, you know, I believe he want to make his brother proud of him.
That's one of the main reasons that I started playing football, because it was for a little league team that I once played for. At first, I used to go out there with my dad. We just go out there and we watch my brother play football out there, because he played football out there. Next thing I know, something just told me. I was like, Dad, I want to play football.
Inspired by his older half-brother, Jaquay Field, Cody suited up. With Jaquay's playing days long over, he became one of Cody's biggest fans, making time to watch his younger brother earn a start at quarterback during Cody's sophomore season at Jones in 2012.
He actually showed up at the game, and I was like, I was real surprised. I was like, whoa, he actually showed up to the game. And I was like, I seen him at the game or whatever. We shook hands, we hugged. He was like, all right, keep on doing your thing out there. You got a whole 2 years ahead of you. So, I mean, whatever happens now is just a minor setback for a major comeback. Just keep doing your thing. And I was like, okay, I got you.
That was the last time Jaquay saw his brother play.
Pulled up and there was yellow tape everywhere.
Houston police believe the teens were playing with a gun. It went off.
I was at my friend's house, we're playing the video game, and I got a call from my dad. My dad was like, Cody, Quay died. And I was like, Daddy, stop playing. He said, Cody, I'm not playing. It was an accidental shooting, supposedly. It was at a friend's house. He was talking to one of his friends. They were outside playing around with, I guess, guns or whatever, and I guess one of the guns went off, and I guess executed my brother, and I guess that was it.
His family's heartache made headlines. Then, in the blink of an eye, the headlines were gone. But the story lives on.
At first, I wanted to give up.
Do you still relive that moment?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it every day for you?
It's every day, and that's the only thing, like football, that's the only thing that I can do to occupy my mind away from stuff like that.
So Cody constantly pushes himself.
Squat too, or just on?
But the loss of his brother has given him more than just physical strength.
Now that I see what happened to him, I'm like, there's no use to me going out in the streets doing something stupid or doing any type of stupidity and end up, you know, either behind bars or in a coffin somewhere. And I was like, football is my only escape. That's the only thing I do, football in school. If I'm not at home, I'm either at school or in some type of enrichment program, or if I'm not there, I'm working out somewhere. It seems like God on one shoulder and my brother on the other. They whispering in both of my ears, keep on going, keep on doing what you love.